In this tutorial video, you will learn how to create split mockup using a single smart object layer. The process that I'm about to teach you is applicable in multiple use cases. You will be able to create split canvas and wall art mockup with a single smart object layer. This method can also be used for mug and tumbler template to show designs in front view, side view, and back views. Let us start this tutorial after this quick intro. So I have this mockup template. You can see three distinct blank frames on the wall. As generally a mockup template do, this mockup template also has a smart object layer named design here. Let me open this smart object layer. To open this, I will double click on the smart object icon. This will open a new rectangle.3 PSB document. Now I am supposed to place the artwork inside this canvas. But I see three new smart object layers. As per the structure here, this template is meant for three different artworks to be displayed as sets. However, what you and I want is to create a template that will perfectly split our artwork into three pieces. Talking about artwork, this is the artwork that I will be working on. I will split it into three parts that will perfectly sit on the blank canvas frames here. To do that, let me close this. I will close this rectangle PSD document. And I will delete this design here layer. This one is not required. And now I will drag our design file and place it on the frame here. Hit enter. We can press Command T or Control T and try to place it on the frames. When you change the opacity, you can see the frames are not perfectly placed and there is inevitable cropping out of the artwork, which we do not want. So what you will do, we'll double click on this smart object icon. This will open a new PSB document, 2.jpg, as per our artwork name. Now once we open this PSB document, you will go to view and create a guides, new guide layout, and we'll have this three layouts, okay, column three. All the other parts, just ignore that. There should be no margin, no gutter, just three columns, and hit on OK. Now, we have three distinct parts as a column. Take the Marquee Selection tool and create a selection snapping to the guides here. We'll create a new layer and you will fill a color. Edit, fill, select any color you want. Maybe I'll select red. Hit OK. To deselect, you will press Ctrl D. Then make a selection of the second part. Again, go to Edit, Fill. Now select a different color. Let me try green. Hit OK. Press Ctrl D to deselect. And finally, our last part. Make the selection. Go to Edit, Fill. And select a layer. Maybe let me try blue this time. Turn OK. So what I'm trying to do is like we are creating three distinct parts which we'll use on the templates while setting it up properly. Now you will go to layers and flatten this image. Don't worry about the missing artwork. You will recover that very soon. You will press Ctrl S to save it and Ctrl W to close this file. Now you can see the artwork that we used is divided into three distinct parts. And what we'll do, we'll try to fit in the red part into this frame, the green part in the second frame, and the blue part on this third final frame. To do that, let me just zoom in and place the perfectly placed on this part. Don't worry about the green and the blue at the moment right now. Let us focus on the red part and the first frame. We'll change the opacity so that we could see beneath what we have. Now the top part and the right corner is perfectly placed. We might need to stretch this artwork to fit in the bottom part. press Command T, and if you hold Shift on your keyboard and then drag this, it will allow you to stretch it. You know, at times you need to stretch the artwork to be displayed in the mockup. This does not mean that the aspect ratio will not look proper. Just to meet the aspect ratio of this, you know, frame, we need to stretch the artworks. Now, if you see our smart object, the red part is perfectly placed on the first frame. Press Ctrl T, maybe we could nudge this a bit here on the right. Now, take the marquee selection tool and make a selection out of the white frame that we see in the first frame, All right. And using this, we'll put a mask on this smart object layer. I think we are perfectly placed now. So we have done this red part on the first frame. Next, we'll follow and do for the green and the blue part. To do that, this step is very important. Just remember, press Command J or Control J if you're in Windows, or you can drag this and create a new copy of this layer. Creating a copy is very important, because what we did here is like we created a new instance of the smart object layer. I will explain this on the later part. Let us first, you know, set the green part. To do that, we'll delete this. Right click on this mask and delete the layer mask. Press the move button here. And then we'll try to place the green part here. Forget about the red now. We need to focus on the green. So at the first instance, if you properly size it, it will be a piece of cake to do. There you go. Perfectly placed. Maybe we need to stretch it on the bottom part a bit. Okay, perfect. Take the marquee selection tool. Create a selection around the second frame. And then select a mask button here. And maybe change the opacity back to 100%. So we have red, green, and then again we'll make a new copy and delete this smart object layer. Mask. We'll delete this mask. Now we see all the three parts. We'll focus on the blue part, and then we'll place it this frame. Maybe a couple of pixels we need to stretch at the bottom. This is too much. I think this is fine. Select the marquee selection tool. Make a selection. And put a mask. And change the opacity back to 100%. Now, you must be loving this. We have three distinct layers, red, green, and blue, defining three equal parts of the artwork that we had, and we have placed exactly on the frames that we desire. Now, I wanted to explain you why we duplicated the smart object layers. When you duplicate the smart object layer, what you actually do is you create a new instance of the same smart object layer. Smart object layers are already smart. So, if you are not aware, I will show you one smart object aspect of the smart object layer. If I open one of the smart object, remember, this controls the blue part. Okay. And the middle part is controlled by this layer. And the red part is controlled by this layer. I will click on this. And I'll try to change the colors. Remember, this controls the blue part. If you remember, this controls the blue part, this layer. And we are working on the top layer. If I change the hue, let us make this orange. Go to layer, flatten this. save this, and I will close this. Did you notice something? I think you noticed. We worked on this, but all the three layers had the same changes reflected on them. That is the magic of the smart object layer. And for you to achieve this, you need to duplicate the layers. To duplicate, either press Ctrl J, Command J, or just drag and place it on this icon over here. But if you remember, we started with the artwork. There are two ways you can place the artwork, and it will perfectly split the artwork into three different frames here. To do that, the easiest way is open a smart object and drag and place our artwork here. Click on layer, flatten, and save this. Close this. Voila! The artwork is perfectly split into three parts and displayed on the frame. So this is what we wanted to achieve. I'll go back and press Ctrl Z. So one method was double click and place the artwork here. A quick method would be right click. Okay, don't right click on the mask, right click on this region, right click and click on replace content, and then drag into the artwork that you have and click on place. Voila! Isn't this amazing? The same concept can be used in templates like this, where you need to show side view, front view, and the back view. Again, for this mockup also, there are three distinct layers controlling three different parts of the mug. But using the concept that I just demonstrated, you can use the same smart object layer and duplicate into three parts to show the right view, front view, and the back view. Similarly, on this mug template as well. So I believe you understand how this method works. If you want to automate your mockup creation process and save hours of your time, you must check out bulkmockup.com. Thank you for watching the video till the end. Do consider subscribing to the channel.